exactly aware of what lupus was. I didn't see people with it. It's not something that's talked a lot about, like cancer and stuff like that on TV. And so my mom, you know, being the mom that how moms are, she's like, you gotta find someone to connect you with that can tell you what you need to do and what to expect. So she connected, my mom's a paralegal, and so she happened to have a client that had a friend that knew someone who had lupus. So she says, I'm gonna connect you guys and you can, you know, learn everything that there is to know about what lupus is. And so I was so excited to meet her because this was the first person I would get to meet that has lupus. So I brought my little notebook and pen and paper, and I went to my mom's office and we met there. And it was an older lady. She came in and she had a cane. She had on sunglasses, a hat. She was really covered up and stuff like that. And I was just looking like, oh my gosh, like what happened? And she came inside and when she came in, she just sat down. She wasn't really friendly. And I'm super friendly. I'm like, hi! Hip replacement surgery, you're probably gonna need shoulder replacement and knee replacement. You'll probably lose all your hair. Make sure you start wearing sunglasses even indoors because the UV lighting is gonna probably mess with you. You might as well just sleep in the daytime and go out at night because you really don't have a light of day. I remember on the inside feeling like, oh my God, I just sunk inside. Like, this is like not what I expected, you know? And so that kind of was the whole inspiration behind House Foundation, because I never, ever wanted anybody to feel that way. I never wanted anybody to feel like once you get this diagnosis, your life is like that. It doesn't have to be, you know? All of us look different. We handle lupus differently. We all go through different things. But I think with positivity, meeting and connecting with other people that we share and help one another, that you can live a healthy life.
And also being proactive. And so that was one of the things that when I first came to the House Foundation, that was my very first support group. So I was very, very, very lucky to have that being my first experience. To come in and I expected, because of what I've seen on TV and what people told me a support group was, you see them in a circle and they're crying and they're talking about all the bad things. So that's what I expected coming in, and I came in with tissues, next to my purse and everything. I was ready, you know, to cry, I was ready. And that's not what I got, you know. So when I left out there, I was like, completely different than what I thought. But I loved it. I'm coming back, you know. But the approach that this group took is one that I recommend to all people, especially if you're newly diagnosed, to, you know, find a support group where their approach is to kind of drive off or build on that positivity, and one that they're gonna, okay, yes, we come together, and there are days our support groups, we talk about what's going wrong, but then we step back and say, okay, what are some alternatives, or what are some solutions that we can present, and we feed off one another. And so the group becomes very, it's a very intimate setting. We try to make it very, to where you feel comfortable, and there's a sense of trust there, because we do experience some very personal things, you know, the effects of lupus, and those are different with everybody. So when I come together with a group of women who I don't understand, so we can come into our group and I'll be like, oh my God, so this pain right here, and I was like, oh my God, I had it too. Like, and you don't have to say too much more, and you don't really have to go into further details. Like, with my mom, I have to explain to her exactly what it feels like. Exactly when I say I'm tired, it's not just I've been working all day.
Yes.
It's not that.
Total different.
It's
kind
a
of
total
tired.
Different tired. You know.
It's like I just got hit by a bus.
You know, and I have to put, I found myself putting it into perspective to her. I'm like, okay, mom, think if the bus was sitting on your chest. that are sitting on you.
And you're swimming in quicksand.
Exactly. And you're sinking. You know, but when you come together in a group of women who get that, you don't have to go, you don't have to be so, you know, it saves so much time. It does. You know, you can just say, I'm tired today, and we totally get it. But with the group being proactive the way that they were, and I just really was grateful to have, you know, be introduced to so many alternative things other than just you have to take all this medication. We don't advocate you coming off your medication at all, but we do introduce alternative things. And that was really big to me, because a lot of us, we go from taking nothing, running marathons, working